General Oketa was a good combatant and also a peacemaker. He contributed enormously in the dislodging of the Forest Peace Movement of Alcina Pena, for those of you who might not remember, in North. Among the battles he's remembered for was the one in 1987 when General Julius Oketa heroically broke the backbone of the Darkin Forest Peace Forces. Defensive position in Conakra in Malay.
For those who knew what was taking place in Conakra, if Lagwana was to be an organized fighter, it was going to be difficult. Because that Conakra was captured with a lot of catchmen of arms. The only small unit that remained behind was that of Oketa. Because of his resilience, he contained the situation and asked for more reinforcement. That's how the situation was saved. He went to Russia, where the president visited him and found what he had done. He was sent for training in Russia. And when he came back, he went to Eastern Uganda, where Pastor the Brigade Commander Benjamin, as the 6th Division Commander. He had his contribution for those who were there.
Again, in 1987, he together with other forces fought a very decisive battle in Soga, defeating the Holy Spirit movement.
But again, because of problems, differences of belonging, you are either UNLA, you are either NRA, he was stressed. He opted to resign, to retire, after retirement, the rank of a lieutenant colonel. And he went into private business. This is a gentleman, Mr. Speaker, sir, who is very unique. There are officers here who are put on Katebe and they complain. General Oketa will never complain, he will find something to do. He will go out, his private business, and he's satisfied to the dismay of many who would ask, but what is he up to? He's not complaining, what is he up to?
General Oketa again contributed during the fight against the Kony forces in 1993 in Arel, and it was a very good battle, and he showed a very good leadership in that battle.
When Oketa retired, the situation in the north couldn't help. I was a young student who had just graduated from university at that time, and we used to go and complain to Honorable Betty Bombe. The war was bad. Roads were impassable. I went to Betty Bombe and challenged him that maybe if you get an actual officer, it can help. See, challenge, he said, but who is that? I said, why don't you bring Oketa back? He said, but he has retired. Then I told Betty. I said, if President Museveni can bring back General Salim Saleh for service, why not come to Oketa? Then she asked me, said, you go and draft a letter. Indeed, I drafted a letter and she signed it, and the president deployed Colonel Oketa. He became the reserve force commander for Northern Uganda. And he did a tremendous work. Many of you know that things were not possible, but God's open. People were able to move.
He also commanded the Battle of Olamuyu, following the enemy massacre of the people in Atia on the 20th of April 1995. See, he has been an officer who accounts for his ranks.
But that was a problem, because his structure was parallel to that of the 4th Division. It caused him a big problem. There was envy. The leadership of 4th Division did not like them at all. And it caused him a problem. Many allegations came on him that perhaps he had a different plan. That unit was disbanded. We are all integrated under the 4th Division. Again, he was left hanging, and he never complained. He did his part. He was such an officer, very humble. He told me in a number, I have done my part.
We have overcome and we have left behind us the issue of who came from which army, as far as the UPDF is concerned. I am a product of the UNLA, which General Oketa served, which Oula served, which General Tumene served. So this is a national army, as I speak. Honorable Speaker, with all the imperfections still with us as UPDF, we have made strides. UPDF is one of the armies within the region where people are coming to do case studies of how we have managed to integrate various armies and various combatants into the national, including NRA. As I speak now, we have combatants who have been in the NRA holding officer ranks in the UPDF. So let's forget about what had happened and we move on.
I would like to take this opportunity, Mr. Baker, sir, to thank in particular two army officers. First one is the president of Uganda, General Yoweri Museveni, and the other one is General Salim Saleh, because they relieved General Oketa a lot of stress out of the pressure he was undergoing. Pressure from within the UPDF. There are some people who never saw this before eye to eye. They regarded us UNLA. And I want to take this opportunity. Let's not give stress to our officers. There's too much stress given to the officers. Mainly for two reasons. One, where you come from. Were you in the NRA or you are in UNLA or federal or what? And the segregation goes on like that. It's a reality. We must be told. That's why some people call themselves historians. Uganda is a sovereign nation. Whoever comes to serve this country serves the sovereignty of this country. Whoever is in uniform, we should respect them as such. Nationalists who are serving our country, irrespective of where one was yesterday, one is today, they are all in uniform serving our country. The moment we continue with this, these officers have fought many wars. They have lost families. They have not had time with their relatives. And you add stress to them. They won't live for long.